royal wedding reception, the menu, speeches, filthy jokes and dancing, secrets revealed. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry were married on May 19, in a spectacle enjoyed by millions of viewers around the world. The after-party, however, was a more private affair for 200 close friends and family. Here are all the juicy secrets from the Frogmore House reception. Prince Charles hosted the Black Tie Bash, described by guests as magical, which began on Saturday evening and raged until the wee hours of Sunday morning. One guest who was sitting with George Clooney said the actor had told him, "I'm really enjoying this wedding because they actually seem to be in love. I go to all these celebrity weddings and nobody seems to be in love at all." Guests were requested to hand their phones over when they arrived to ensure the celebrity-packed party remained private, but plenty of juicy details have been obtained by the Sunday Times. Here they are. The speeches. Harry's best man, his big brother Prince William, led the way, apparently opening the speeches with filthy jokes that had the crowds roaring with laughter. Guests are keeping tight-lipped on the content of the jokes, but they are said to have revolved around women's knickers. Harry's oldest friend Charlie Van Straubenzee, who William introduced as God's gift, Charlesworth, then took over and proceeded to poke fun at his pal Harry. Van Straubenzee told guests how Harry was his dormitory monitor when he arrived at Ludgrove School in Berkshire aged 8. "All I wanted was a cuddle from my mommy," he said. Instead, Harry nicked my teddy bear and chucked it out on the roof. "Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you, how can you put someone in charge of a dorm when that someone is worse behaved than the whole dorm room combined?" Van Straubenzee also teased Harry for his red hair, calling him our strawberry blonde prince, and saying, "Let's face it, Harry's a ginger. He was in denial for years, when he was young and used to hate other gingers." Crowds were said to be in stitches when Van Straubenzee teased Harry about his penchant for falling off polo horses, saying, "He's always so hungover when he plays." On a more serious note, Van Straubenzee then turned to talk of tough times, seeing his friend going through the loss of his mother, Princess Diana, in 1997. One guest said, he described how awful it had been for Harry to go through everything and how he has come through it. He told Harry how happy his mother would have been that he was found love with Meghan and how excited she would be to see them starting their lives together as a married couple. Harry was pretty emotional at that point. Van Straubenzee then turned his praise to the phenomenal Meghan, thanking her for making his friend so very happy. It was Harry's turn to take the mic next, and he is said to have led with a tribute to his dad, the Prince of Wales, thanking him for all the love he gives him and his brother. He also thanked Meghan's mum Duriya Ragland for her amazing daughter, my wife, which a guest said had the whole room cheering. Harry is said to have ended his speech by turning to the glowing Meghan and telling her she looked simply stunning, and that he felt very, very lucky to have you by my side. And then, guests say, he told them all to have a serious party. Meghan closed off the speeches, making history as the first royal bride to speak at her wedding. One guest said Meghan thanked the Queen and the rest of the royal family for making her feel so welcomed. She thanked Prince Charles especially for walking her down the aisle after her father couldn't make it, and for being so kind to her mother. Guests said she said plenty of lovely things about her new husband too. After the speeches ended, James Corden surprised everyone with a performance in full Tudor dress-up, making an entrance saying, "Your Royal Highnesses, ladies and gentlemen, I had no idea what to wear to a royal wedding so I looked it up in the Royal Etiquette Manual and found this outfit." The music. The earlier parts of the evening saw guests dancing to a soul band singing classics such as In the Midnight Hour, Soul Man, and My Girl. Actor Idris Elba got the party started later in his role as DJ, with one guest describing banging nightclub music which kept guests boogieing until the early hours. The menu, food and drinks. Chef Claire Smythe, protege of celebrity chef Gordon Ramsay, was in charge of the menu for the evening. Here is what guests tucked into. Pre-dinner aperitifs and canapés. peach bolognese and champagne served with hoisin duck and organic Dutchy home farm beef carpaccio canapes. Starters: potato and roe with bourdon, herring and trout roe. Main course: 64-day-aged roast chicken, a reference to Harry proposing to Meghan while trying to roast a chicken, with sage, onion and veggies. Pudding: wild strawberries and lemon verbena. Cheese: Lincolnshire cheddar. Late night snacks from 1 a.m. Toasted Gruyere and truffle cheese toasties. Bacon sandwiches. Mini burgers. Wine, beer and liqueur, bar and cocktails by Jack Chaplin. Old World Wine, Bourgogne Les Settles Olivier Leflerive, Burgundy. New World Wine, Domaine Eden Pinot Noir, Santa Cruz Mountains, California. 10-year-old Somerset Cider Brandy. Core beer from Two Tribes Brewery, West Sussex. Port wine gums, made with Taylor's Port, 1984, from Prince Harry's christening. And so, as the magical, decadent evening finally ended and guests had to drag themselves away, one of them said, "None of us ever wanted to leave. It seems certain to be a night none of them will ever forget."